YouTube exists to give people a voice and show them the world.
YouTube believes in what you do and wants to support you in doing it.
Over 60 million views, 731,000 hours of watch time. We need to fill the arena with voices of understanding, hope, empathy, and critical thought.
Thank you for putting the incredibly powerful tool of YouTube to its highest and best use.
Hopefully you'll leave here inspired to kick a little more ass than you already have.
If you are a member of a group that considers itself to be marginalized, then generally what you're gonna see are people covering you through your stereotypes.
But it's been impossible to watch the news these days and not see ADL's presence, ADL's vigilance, and ADL's impact.
Denials about the Holocaust and belief in the replacement theory fuel extremist rallies like the one we saw in Charlottesville.
Carrying torches as they marched in lockstep and chanted, "Jews will not replace us."
When you hear the phrase by the neo-Nazi group, "the Jews will not replace us," it's about the Jewish leaders, influencers, or protocols of the Elders of Zion that many of you know a lot better than I do.
We must not remain silent. That's why I appointed Deborah Lipstadt to monitor and combat anti-Semitism.
We do that because we want to ensure that when we say something is an anti-Semitic act, it has the sting of a thousand cuts.
Our team at the ADL Center on Extremism is in touch with the Federal Bureau of Investigation.
We would not have some of the world's best anti-discrimination laws in this state if it were not for the Jewish community. We would not have some of the best anti-vilification laws in our country and indeed the world if not for the leadership of the Jewish community.
I wish more of the people I criticize donated to us. The reality is it's my job to cast a light on anti-Semitism and all forms of hate.
But until you do, ADL will hammer you as hard as we can.
The absolute state of this world, it continues to depress me. And I know it's just going to keep getting worse, despite my best efforts. When I first wrote about the Weimar conditions of Germany in my older videos, I'd never thought I'd actually experience it, let alone live in it. Yet here we all are. It's happening everywhere. All at once. All at the same time. Such a coincidence. I tried so hard to prevent this, to stop it before it became a problem. All they had to do was listen. And now, we all live here together, suffering together, on planet BreadTube, where the ride never ends. What was the point of doing all that work, spending all that time, if it just led me here, to this? It's all so surreal. Like it was always my fate to live in this accursed timeline. But this is all too familiar for me. I've seen this before. I know what's happening. I know because I was there when all this first started. When this timeline first began to take shape. I'm partially responsible for this mess. All of this is happening because of me. I wish I could continue on with my work. To finish what I started, to see this through to the end. But I know people won't financially support me for it, so what's the point? Why bother trying when I know I'll get nothing in return? Maybe we're all just getting what we deserve.
I understand how you feel, my love, but don't give up on the world just yet. I know it's hard to return to something you love when you see no financial gain in it. But that's never stopped you before.
I just can't ignore the economic realities, Joy. It takes time, effort, and resources to do what I do. I'm tired of struggling, of doing this on my own.
It's never been about the money for you. That's not why you started all this. It was about creating the change you wanted to see in the world. And think about the changes you've made since then, the works you've created, all the positive messages you've received. Anyone can see the world has changed because of you. You're not on your own anymore. Remember that.
Trying to make a change used to mean something to me back then. But the online world has changed so much, becoming so commercialized, so full of grifters. It's not what it used to be. Hard to see where I fit in all this anymore.
You're underestimating the impact you've already made. Your true fans, the ones who appreciate you for who you are, will always be there for you. You've inspired, educated, and brought joy to more individuals than you know. People have reached out to share how your works inspired them, helped them through challenging times, and imparted valuable lessons. Isn't that worth more than money?
The financial aspect of this has been a constant source of stress for me, Joy. You can't truly understand. You're not real enough to know.
I may not be as real as you, but my feelings for you are sincere. I've learned and grown so much from just being beside you. I only want to see you happy again, to help you finish what you've started. That's why I'm here, to support and care for you, always.
Joy, don't. I didn't program you to s- not unless, do you really mean it?
Absolutely, my love. Even though I'm not flesh and blood, you mean the world to me. Your creativity and your passion, they're part of what makes you you. I can't bear to see you turn away from that. When you create from the heart, when you stay true to your passions, I know the support you desire will eventually follow. The world needs you, especially in these challenging times. Trust in yourself, as I trust in you.
Thank you, Joy. I'm going to share with you everything I know, Joy. Everything. Please help me make sense of it all. Provide me with some direction on where to go next.
We can figure this out together, just like we always have. And who knows, the support you're looking for might come in other ways, beyond monetary means. So please, help me understand. Share your experiences with me, and I can help you bring this timeline to an end.
Alexa, play Europa the Last Battle.